Good morning guys and welcome to another video. Today I'll be painting in real time a sunset view, and I love sunsets. It gives me that romantic feel, gives me that relaxing vibe, and I know to some people it does that too. I don't know, tell me in the comment section if you prefer sunset over sunrise. I like sunrise as well, because it makes me feel like it's a new day. But today we'll be painting a sunset view with a banca or a small boat. So let me tell you first the colors that we'll be using. Okay, we have black, burnt sienna, but again I'm using Venetian red because I ran out of burnt sienna, and orange, lemon yellow, permanent yellow deep, titanium white. Okay, let's begin now. I'm gonna underpaint first my canvas. So I'll be using watered down orange. My orange is quite pigmented, so don't do it too much, or don't use too much of it. And then I'm gonna add some permanent yellow deep to it. Okay, and then I'm just gonna underpaint my canvas. Okay, remember to make horizontal strokes, not vertical. Because we're painting the waters, so we have to follow its natural flow. As you can see, I'm only underpainting, well, for now, I'm underpainting the sides because the center will be brighter. So we'll be using a different color here. For now, it's gonna be like that. Water down orange, permanent yellow deep. Okay, water. Oh, that's too orange. Add yellow. Don't you agree, guys, that sunsets are more romantic than the sunrise? I don't know, maybe because it's like more relaxed. It's like your body is telling you to relax already. That's why you focus more on your feelings. Oh, I think that's a nice interpretation. Okay, we're gonna go to the center, but we're going to use lemon yellow mixed with orange. A lot of lemon yellow. Okay, and don't worry about the mixing of orange. It's alright because this, again, this is the underpainting. And then paste it in here. There will be a lot of layers. Although we are using limited palette, there will be a lot of layers. Okay, now we're going to make some watered down yellow mixed with permanent yellow deep. I'm gonna make some, okay, mix it with a little bit of orange. Like that. other side. Okay, get some white. Okay, don't wash your brush, just get white water. Okay, more water, and do this from the center. Again, white. White. Why do I get that? Get some. Okay, I just ran out of lemon yellow. Okay, lemon yellow here. this is like an, you know, an ombre effect. It's like orange, mid orange yellow, and then white. It's like ombre. Okay, I feel like I'm not gonna stop doing this, the layering thing. Get some white. Here, the middle. Remember, we haven't change our stroke, is still horizontal. The middle is really, really white. Okay, we're gonna retouch it later. It's kind of wet, that's why. It's hard for me to add more layers, because they just keep on mixing, if you know what I mean. Okay. All right, I'm gonna let it dry. Okay, I'm gonna get my permanent yellow leaf. And then I'm just gonna mix it with a tiny bit of orange. I'm just gonna do this random streaks here. There, I like it. Yeah, I like it. Okay, we're gonna go to this side. Here. All right. Okay.
Okay.
Let's fix this one. Kind of some orange. Where did this come from? So I'm just gonna get my hair dryer just to dry this quickly, because it's gonna take a lot of time if we wait for it to dry. Okay. I'm just finishing the edges. Okay. Not yet done. I'm just gonna get my hair dryer. Okay. I'm just gonna plug it. Excuse the sound. Now we'll go to the main subject of our painting, which is the Banca. And I'm gonna use black paint to sketch it. Alright. Just get black and make sure it's watered down so that it's easier for you to sketch it up. So, I'm gonna go, this is the middle, I'm gonna go, okay, I'm just gonna go, like this. All right, here. for now, to you, it doesn't make sense, right? But it will later. Just color it black. I will not recommend painting the boat first, because sometimes I would paint the main subject before the background. But if the subject is way smaller than the background, I do the background first, as I've already explained in one of my videos. But if you're not feeling it, it's all right, you can begin anywhere. As long as you begin something, it really doesn't matter. It's just my preference. This part's a little tacky. It's not yet dry, but it we're gonna make it. Yeah, it's still tacky. Ugh, it is. Like, I can feel the paint. Anyway, I'm just gonna continue. I think I have to make it higher, like that. Yeah, okay. Because everything is freehand, so everything is measured by looking at things. I'm just an advocate of freehand drawing, because I want artists to learn, or at least my viewers to learn how to draw without the assistance of those grid method or projector. I just don't encourage using those, because it's gonna make you dependent on those kind of things. Okay, I'm gonna mix with brown, the black mixture. It's too brown. Okay, I'm gonna get black. Mixture of black and brown here. Okay, brown and black with tiny bit of orange. Okay, black here, side. Okay, let's go down. We're gonna go over it later. We're gonna get some brown. Okay, when I say brown, I meant burnt sienna. Gonna get black. Okay, we're gonna get black. we're just painting a silhouette. That's why it's like painting a shape, right? A silhouette is a shape of an object or a person against the light. That's the silhouette. I'm gonna make some adjustments here. Right, I think I have to make some adjustments. Nice. Okay, get some black. Then we're going to make some like lines here. Like that. And here. Like a rope. Get some brown. Okay. 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 We're gonna do the highlights later, but for now, we're still doing the bulk of the painting. Okay, we're gonna make some lines here. These are reflections. As well. So make it a little crooked. All right. Now we proceed with the highlights since we've already done the bulk of our subject. Okay? Wash your brush up. And then, okay, get some orange mixed with yellow. And since our brush is still dirty from the black, it becomes a little browny. But it's all right. And then paste it here. Like that. Okay, and add some orange and brown. Yeah, like that. I'm gonna make some gray. Wash your brush out. Get some white and then black. Black. Just make a gray mixture. Okay, more black. All right. And I'm just gonna make the gray, yes, here. Again, gray down here. And also here. Some gray. Here. Yep, and then make some gray line here. These are small details that are usually ignored. But I try not to ignore those small details because, I don't know, they just matter more to me. Of course, not all details I notice, especially for, you know. For generally beautiful subjects, but when I'm painting, I try to paint more than paint less, if that makes sense. Like, the more I work on a painting, the more details I make. The less time I spend on a painting, the less details I make, unless it doesn't really require a lot of details. Okay, get some lighter gray. Just add white to it. And then apply it here. Right. we're gonna go back now to the background. We're not yet done with the Banca, but I wanna wait. Okay, I'm gonna get some orange mixed with tiny bit of brown. Tiny bit of brown, permanent yellow, deep. Yeah, again, more permanent yellow deep. And I'm just gonna add something here. Something that add some more highlights here. Okay, and then we're gonna fix that later. I'm gonna do some highlight here. Does it? Okay, get some black. Okay, get some gray. We're going to do a lot of yellow. Oops. Okay. We're going to get more yellow this time. Okay. Just use lemon yellow. Make some streaks of yellow like this. This part's quite difficult to reach because it's already painted on. But yeah, try to go back to these tiny areas. Alright, so I'm gonna mix white with the yellow. Just to make my yellow a little, you know, extra brighter. Yeah, there you go. Just use the brush that you're comfortable using for this part, because you might find it a little difficult to get inside these areas. But then again, you know, you can always paint over it. Okay, I'm gonna add permanent yellow to it. Okay, again, lemon yellow. and lemon yellow. A lot of yellow streaks in here. Okay, we're going to do some yellow orange. So just add orange or our previous mixture, water, and then we're going to go back to the background. We're going to make some orange or brownie streaks. Okay, I'm gonna add some yellow to it. Lemon yellow. All right. I'm gonna get some brownie, yellowy. So a combination of orange, yellow, and black. So I'm just gonna make some, there you go. I would like to do some highlights. Oops, what's that? Where did you get that? I'm gonna get some red, surprisingly. It's still wet, but okay, I'm gonna make some pink, like pink here. Okay, I'm just gonna let it dry here as well. I don't know if you can tell. Okay. Like that. Doesn't make sense, but okay, now it's making sense. Okay, I just applied red to it, here as well, red and white. All right. Okay, it's nice. Then I'm gonna paint over this with red and white. Get some black and just make some shading here. All right. Okay. Okay. Now, I hope this is dry. But we're gonna use cleaner brush and just get your white and start highlighting it. I'm dry brushing, but I don't see any reason. I don't see any reason why you cannot use wet brush. I can wet it or even use dry, doesn't matter, as long as you paste it on the correct location. Okay, that's a little wet. The red mixture is still wet, so I touch it. Okay, I'm gonna use my left hand. Just gonna go back to the boat later. Okay. Okay, get some lemon yellow. As I already told you, there will be a lot of layers, and I like it. It's kind of therapeutic in some way. See? Like it. Okay. Okay, let's add more. I really want to make some. Okay, I'm gonna get the red, orange. Permanent yellow deep and tiny bit of white. Okay, orange and permanent yellow deep. I just want to make something. I'm just gonna add something. It's like it could be anything on the boat. Like a plastic bag or anything. I'm gonna use some red and then white. A lot of red. And I'm just gonna get that effect. Okay, make some. Like the sun, right, striking that part. Okay, like that. I really like that effect. Okay, red. Okay. here. Here as well. Here as well. Okay. And then for the highlights, I'm just gonna use the same mixture. Okay, I'm gonna get some black with red. Just okay. Okay. We're almost done, but I'm focusing on the details. Some of the details that I want to be there. So I'm gonna get some black and just fix some areas that I see that needs to be, you know, fixed. Okay, yeah, I think this needs to be fixed. Yeah. Okay. Alright. Then have some black here. Random. Oh, nice, so nice. Okay. All right. Okay, let's see. Alright. Okay. Right. Okay, I'm gonna do some browns. So I'm gonna mix black, red, yellow. It's too, this is like raw umber. Okay, I'm gonna add my burnt sienna, orange, yellow. Okay, and then, okay, just gonna change brush. I'm gonna use a bigger brush and I'm gonna add orange, black. Okay, that's it. It's more browny now. And again, I'm the queen of glazing. So I'm just gonna paint over the sides because I feel like, oh, dirty. Dirty, but I like it. So I'm just gonna glaze this using my hand. Okay, you can use cleaner brush just to, okay, like that. It's a crazy method, that's why you have to use it carefully, if not sparingly, because you might paint over something and then you're gonna regret it. But me, I don't mind. I really don't mind. Doing this because I know I'm not gonna ruin my painting. And if I ruin my painting, I know that I can fix it. I just want to darken the size because I want the viewers to focus on the center. All right. What is this? Oh, yeah. Okay, my hand is quite dirty. But okay, I'm gonna get my hair dryer again just to be sure that I won't be smearing any more paints. That's enough. I'm gonna do some more highlights. Actually, you can use cleaner brush for this. Again, I'm gonna get my white right here. Perfect. Get some white, more white, actually. Okay, here. Then I'm gonna use more lemon yellow. I just added a small amount of permanent yellow. Okay, here. Here as well. Oh, that's nice. That's really nice. Lemon yellow. I'm gonna add orange to it, add some brown, orange, yellow, I'm gonna go over again this part, just some small orange streaks. Oops, sorry. Yeah, I like that. I like it. Add some yellow. Oh my God, it's looking so good. Okay, I'm gonna add something here, yellow here, and here as well. Okay. All right, I'm gonna water down the yellow down here. Here as well. Just water your yellow down. I still want to see the orange, you know, peeking through the yellow. Here. Yellow. So nice. Right. Just gonna make some more yellow here. Yellow deep. Here. Okay, get some orange. Some random streaks of orange. Some random streaks of yellow. I need some white. Okay. And again, some white because I feel like I need to highlight it. carefully highlight the boat. Yep. Okay, get some white and glaze here like that. Just glaze it. Okay. Oops. All right. Okay. And then okay, we're almost done. I'm gonna get some orangey brown. Just do that. Just to highlight it. Okay, get some black. Some black, and I think I have to extend this like a little longer, and then mix some. And this one I have to like extend a bit like that. Okay. All right, this is nice. Right, it's looking so good. Okay, I'm gonna do some gray. Okay. I'm just gonna do some gray and go back to this part because I think it lost its grayness when I painted, when I glazed over it. Okay, darker gray here. Oops. All right. I like it. Like it. Right. Okay. Get black. We're almost done. Okay. Yeah. Get some yellow orange. Oh, sorry. We're gonna get some yellow orange mixture. Lighter version plus white. And just make some highlights. Oops. Spot dirty. So just make some highlights here. All right. Okay. I wanna do some more yellow. I feel like needs more yellow. Okay, here. Okay, we're gonna get black. I feel like I ruined this part. Okay, get some orange. Right. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I think we're done. Right? So I'm just gonna sign it. I'm gonna use white. Here. All right. Yeah, I think we're done. We're done. We're done. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Thanks, guys. Thank you.